Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Arm, Enhanced Edition, and stuff. We're heading back to...
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Athketla? We left some people in the slums. Specifically the inn, the Copper Coronet. I want to see if they have any more extra healing potions. Or any healing potions at all, actually. We travel.
You don't seem comfortable.
Somebody's about to run up to us.
Forgive me, dear elf. It is just that I have never understood the city.
What is there to understand? Cities are where you go when you have no place else to be. Really? Perhaps that is it. I have my grove, and the beauty tethers my heart to its ferns and mosses. When next we visit, would you like me to show them to you? Oh, please, Cernd, I would like that very much. Then it shall be so.
Igarol, I would know your mottled hide anywhere. How are you?
Making time with the area here, but... Saved by the Igarol. Do I know you? No. I do not think I really do. Get on. Okay, crashed a desktop for some reason, but... It's like I alt-tab out. I'm gonna restart. It's like I alt-tabbing without really alt-tabbing. It does that sometimes. I don't know why it dumps me there. So why'd he come over, right? The years have taken your memory, Igarol. Even though the greatest crags are eroded by the rivers of time, it is Cernd, and once you called me neighbor. I did not say I did not remember you. I said that I did not know you, and that I am sure. The Cernd I knew was killed years ago, and your foul apparition took his place. Really? I don't know why you say that, but I assure you it is I. Like the hair changes coats to suit the season, I am different but the same. You must see that I know what you are. You are a shadow of the Cernd that took a wife and called me neighbor. You are the pale reflection of the decent man that worked the lands with me. Now I serve the lands. Is that such a change? Surely you see that my greater duty... Still you do not see. I question not your service to the lands, but do not speak to me of duty when you are the one who abandoned his wife. She understood, even if you do not. She saw that my fate was to serve nature. There was no room for the mundane activities of city living. She understood. Understood what? No, Cernd. How could you ask her to understand something that you do not? Yes, nature called to you and you went, but no doubt you were afraid to stay. Just because you say it was your fate does not mean you did it for noble reasons. You were frightened of the life that lay before you, and you left. Simple as that. Well, you certainly may claim to know much of what happened between me and Galia alone. I left on good terms, I left in good faith, and I left her well taken care of. Cernd, you left her with child. What? Oh boy. With child, Cernd, you left with your child on the way. I never heard. When did she... Within 9 months of your leaving, I would imagine. Not quite as attuned with nature as you thought, eh? Or did you subconsciously know and left because of it? This guy's very judgmental. I'm sorry, Cernd, but you left a large mess behind for other people to fix. If you've come to clean it up, you will find that you are far too late. At least tell me how she is. She is well, isn't she? Speak to me, Igarol, please. Very well, but what has happened is not easily undone. Go see for yourself, Cernd. Go to the house you called home and see what you left behind. You'll find your way from there, I am sure. I thank you, Igarol. Even though this news is most troubling, I must speak with Gaily and tell her my thoughts. Yes, well, go to the house. Then you will see. Cernd's child. We encountered Igorol, funny name, an old friend of Cern's. He bitterly informed Cernd that the wife he abandoned to become a druid had been carrying his child. Igorol wouldn't say what became of Cern's wife, but did say that he should go to his old house in Joaquin's Promenade to find out more. Alright, where's his house then? Because I was going to go to Adventure Mart.
I am sorry. Oh. It appears we have run into some skeletons of mine. I am sure this will be straightened out in time, so if we could make haste to my old home, I would appreciate it.
Well, we're not going to be judgmental also, so... I'm not picking three. You do not seem too sure of your words. Your welcome may well be a cold one. I must take this path. I did care for Galia, but it was not meant to be. I thought I had laid these things to rest, but it appears I didn't do a very good job. Perhaps I did seek simpler things, but I meant no harm and thought I provided well enough. Please, I should go find my old home. Let's go. Well, I was trying to find your old home. Cern's former home. Okay, there we go. Can we hit Adventurer Mart first? It's like right there.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Okay, that's the former home there. Adventurer Mart over here. I'm thinking about trying to steal things. You can't stop me.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
A rube soon after, huh? Do we need bullets? Should check that. No healings. Don't see any healings. I'd say we're okay for now, I guess. Alright, now we've got this ammo belt. Lots of arrows in there. Okay, sorry about that. Let's see, antidotes. Got two. I'll try to make sure everyone has like at least two of them. Alright, so we need some for these two. Alright, four antidotes. That's exactly how much he has. Wow. Yeah, he was out. Okay. Glory of Arm. Glory of Arm. Yeah, glory. Okay. Is it this?
Stand back for justice!
For all I know, we've been in here already and looted the place. Alright, I'll be moving, Gov. No need to get your boots out. Hey, you ain't no city guard. Push off. This here is my squad. Get your own. I would, my friend, but this is my home, and it is you who intrude. Well, it was my home, but the winds of nature did take my sails, and I had to follow the least wise you could tell the truth if and you're gonna talk. I know you ain't the owner. He wouldn't show his face here. Abandon his wife, they say. Yes. Well, I'm sure he had his reasons. Often it is best to obey the duties of your calling and serve the greater... Maybe you is him. You talk like him. He had a load of reasons, too, and I mean a load. Ain't no wonder she hooked up with that bastard when old Nature Boy left. Now we wonder. Maybe it's the other guy's child. She? Where is she? Where is the lady of the house gone? I notice everyone likes to interrupt him. Is he, like, supposed to be characterized as being long-winded or something? Galia? I just know she took her little in and went looking where she could for help. Get lost, Nature Boy. No sympathy from me. Please, good sir, I must know where she has gone. Must? Of all the people, it is you that should know. But now you gotta ask the gutter boy? I say, you a sad one. Go ask Phinesia. Maybe she pity you, too. Phinesia? She was a serving girl. I was about to ask about her as well. I bet you were. Well, she's turned nanny now. Ain't put up the steps. Don't think she'd be as sympathetic, though, having to take Nature Boy's place. You needn't continue to chastise. I have learned my humble position, and I shall walk with due care as a ground squirrel must scurry amidst the feet of... Yammer, yammer, yammer. Save it for someone who cares. Some coins for you regardless. Farewell. Thanks, Gov. Send it to me, kids. I knows where mine are. In Cern's home, we encountered a beggar who remembered Cern's wife and their servant, Phinesia. He said that Phinesia was now working as a nanny in her home, which should be on my map. He did not know what happened to Cern's wife, though Phinesia certainly might.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
I have that book. Plain arrows. I have that book as well. Oh, there's a sack or something here. And a box. Huh. 19 gold and a dagger. Well, if we were in here that was either repopulated or... I missed it somehow.
Well, that was unpleasant. I guess I should expect more of the same to come. As the trees are buffeted and snapped in the face of the gale, I shall be as the bamboo and flex.
You have a lot of, I forget what they call that exactly. It's comparing something to something else. There's a lot of that. This all has to do with nature, right? It's an analogy, right? Oh, shut up. Be supportive. A good attitude. You will need it if you wish a second chance from these people. You're right. I am deserving of their scorn. I hope my wife, Galia, is forgiving. I thought we had an understanding. Come, the house is but up the steps. I guess they didn't have divorces back then. They just stay married forever.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Make way, villainy! Deadbeat dad coming through. Just kidding. So we'll go up these stairs. Is everyone just like really coming down on him? And if I knew him better, I'd feel bad, but we kind of just met him.
It is interesting to me that the most ardent builders of cities look to nature for their forms and tools.
Oh, where else are you gonna find them? It makes me think I've been here because all the doors are already open. We must party, gather our party before venturing forth.
Ah, Phoenicia. You are as I remember you.
Phoenicia.
You look unsure. It is Cernd, your former employer, I hope you recall.
I am unsure because you are probably as I remember you as well, a scared little man that runs out on those that need him most. I have nothing to say to you. Oh boy. Phoenicia, please, I have come to speak with Galia. Is she here? Our old home is deserted. She's dead, Cernd. You needn't worry about her getting in the way of your duty anymore. She's dead. Dead, but... Igorol... Phoenicia, what happened? Tell me. I said I had nothing to say to you. Get out. Oh boy. Cern spoke with Phoenicia, but she is obviously angry with him, saying only that his former wife, Galia, was dead. She won't say anything more with Cern in a room. Perhaps if I spoke to her alone. Oh, really?
Butt kicking, for goodness!
Yeah, I think I've been in here. So we should leave.
You point, I punch. Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Well, I'd like to do the honors, actually. So... my charisma's 15, which is pretty good. But... it can be even better. Let me borrow this, Minsk. The Flail of Ages. Right. Okay. I am charisma 18. Look at this. Coming down the steps. So funny. You gonna go down those steps too? Look at that. I like it. Alright, should I just go in by myself or should I bring someone?
Swords! Jump on my sword while you can, Eva.
Swords!
I won't be a
scandal.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs!
Oh, wait. If it's gonna take effect, I have to be the...
I deserve to be leader.
Yes, I have to be leader. Just trying to have best possible outcome against Cernd, perhaps. Or for Cernd, I mean. Against him.
Such menial tasks.
It's important, though.
Oh, it's been a tough year, but things are bound to improve.
You should choose better company. That one just ain't right, running out on a woman like that. I do want to know what happened. He has a different view of it. He claims it was for the best and that it was a mutual decision. Yes, well, he would, wouldn't he? It doesn't matter, really. What's done is done, and there's not a damn thing he can do to make it better. I'll tell you what happened to the best of my knowledge, which will certainly be better than his recollection, I am sure. He left because he was afraid. Afraid of settling down and leaving his blessed nature. Galia went along with their breakup so she wouldn't, quote-unquote, hold him back. Doesn't matter because their deal was broken when she found out she was pregnant. So Galia took comfort where she could. A local noble named Daryl. Daryl. I know a Daryl. What's Daryl's last name? Their deal was broken when she found out she was pregnant. Oh, you mean their mutual thing? Well, he never found out that, I mean, supposedly. I believe him. He was generally surprised. I think Daryl. Fine man to look at, but cold in the eyes. I treated her bad. Didn't get any better when she gave birth. Got worse, to tell you the truth. Galia died a few months ago. I ain't saying nothing, but it didn't seem natural. No fuss made. Daryl's got a wallet for the guard, if you get my drift. Daryl. Galia's son, Cern's son, is with Daryl now. No doubt the boy will be an unthinking lout, if not from the family line, then from example. This cannot be a healthy environment for a child. The guard will do nothing. The guard will do what to who? The child is an orphan of a woman whose husband ran off. They are less than garbage in this town. If he wants to make amends, Daryl's at his home, the southernmost mansion in the government district. Daryl. That's probably where I know it from the map. The Daryl Estate. Too late, though. Damage was done 2 years ago. Phoenicia said that after the birth of Cern's child, Galia had taken up with a cold noble named Daryl. Daryl didn't treat her well, and she died recently under strange circumstances. Daryl, being a noble, is above investigation. The baby remains with Daryl in his home, the southernmost mansion in the government district. Okay. Anything else to say? Go on. I'm done talking to you. Oh, that would be a no, then. Okay. We can't talk to people anymore, I know. Sometimes,
a simple matter.
Sometimes I try and nothing happens. Alright, Daryl Estate.
Fine.
Everything, sir? Not sure which is quicker. I'll go this way. So we're learning about Cernd. He must be very embarrassed about this. Brand new people he just met. It's like, oh great, they're judging me too. Government district. Daryl Estate here. Good.
Such menial tasks.
I might have been in there as well. I'm not sure. You know me. I try to get in everywhere. Okay. So I got a new mouse coming. It's delayed. This is a new mouse. It's not working right. So sometimes if you see me struggling and pausing, that's why. Southernmost? Yeah, I guess it is. It's more like the southeasternmost. I have to try to, and I did order another one, just in case, but I have to try to just... Yeah, mess with the drivers. Uninstall, reinstall, that kind of thing. But I really like this mouse, but it's got this intermittent issue. Oh! Glut? It's a golem, I guess. I see you. I got specialized just for the likes of you. Who are you? You ain't got business here. And what do you know what the likes of me is, if you don't know me? I should say I do. I would speak with your master, Daryl. Do be quick about getting him, will you? He don't speak to no one. You will leave. As the simple wasp must coerce the flower to release its nectar, oh, brother, so I will rip your throat from its moorings and drain your lifeblood if I do not see Daryl and my child. Understand? I don't think golems have blood. Well, you sure sound like his other guests. He doesn't like to be disturbed, but I will tell him you are here. Maybe you are just late for the party, or whatever. Maybe this isn't a golem. They're not really talking. He's got, like, an attitude. A golem is kind of, sort of like a robot. Only a magical robot, not a technological robot. Yeah, this sounds different. Good man, good man. You go now and get him. Yeah, and he's saying good man to a golem. Could you be a little less insane? Yeah, I like to say that. Could you be a little less insane, please? I'd like to get out of here alive. I'm not exactly sure what came over me. Glad it passed, but it seemed to do the trick. Let's see what our thick friend brings back with him. That. Okay.
Who disturbs? I have guests that will not tolerate interruptions.
Glut should have known this. You destroyed Glut. Why the hell would you call him Glut? I disturb. I would have words with you. You? And who might you be? There is something about your eyes that I recognize. Who are you? I am called Cernd, and we have business to discuss. Well, I know that name, though those that knew you call you several others. By their description, I would have not expected you to ever return. Well, it is here. I am here, and we have matters that we must discuss. I think not. I am done with you and your kin. What is it you think we must speak of? I am sure I will find your answer amusing. My wife and her death. My child and his life. Ah, she is long since gone. If I began ignoring her while she was still here, why can't you release yourself after years? Best you learn to control yourself. If I began ignoring her while she was still here, why can't you release yourself after years? What exactly is that supposed to mean? I don't know. As for the boy, that must be why I recognize your eyes. He has never known you. What claim have you to him? Do you even know his name? So maybe he means that, like, well, she was here alive for all this time, and you never came to check up on her. Now that she's dead, here you are, kind of thing. That's the only thing I can glean from that sentence. Why you've gone for years. Well, you just found out. No, you do not, do you? No one has told you, and you have not been here. What claim have you? Can we speak up and help him? I am the child's father and rightful guardian. Okay, so we're talking to Cernd. Accuse him of the murder. If we threaten to bring the guards into it, he may relinquish the child. We will back you if you threaten him. That's giving up the quest, I guess. We can beat and just kill. Okay. he's right there. I guess we're whispering it in Cern's ears. Cernd, accuse him of the matter of Galia. If we threaten to bring the guards into it, he may relinquish the child. I am the child's father, and I make claim that you murdered the mother. Galia died in your care, and the guards of this city will... Ha ha! I buy the guards when I need to. Besides, how sure are you? Perhaps she took her own life, pining for your return, weeping over your picture. Shut up. Crying for the day her brave Cernd would return and take her away. He's gonna flip out. Shut up. Until she could take it no more, and, whispering your name, sipped a hemlock-laced wine, ending her torture. Or maybe I push her down the stairs. Take your pick. I will tear your eyes as the raven. Yeah, we're with you, Cernd. Let's get him. It would have been better for you to find a non-violent solution, but now I have entertainment for my guests. Come to my side, my comrades. Enjoy the spectacle. Who's joining? Legolgon?